In times of disasters, preparation and proper education are key to survival. And now you can do this with just a few clicks on Hazard Hunter PH. This web application developed by the Science and Technology Department allows a user to be in the know if their location is prone to hazards, also providing information to help people better understand the risks. And now to tell us more about this project, joining us today is John Harold Tabuzo and Hans Cesar Alejandria, Science Research Specialist at the Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology, or FIVOL. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us here on Early Edition. Now, I can see you, of course, working on our computer because you will show us Hazard Hunter PH. But then I just want to start first. What is Hazard Hunter? Paano ba ito na-develop, and what was the need, of course, to have this kind of application for the people?
Well, Hazard Hunter is the first publicly available online application in the Philippines, even in the world. And it answers the question, what hazards am I exposed to? Is my house or property or business or the property I am planning to buy or the places that I frequently visit safe from hazards? How far am I or how near am I to the nearest active fault or active volcano, and what should I do if the place I assessed for hazards is exposed to either seismic, volcanic, or hydrometeorological hazard?
So right now, Hans, this very timely because, of course, Tropical Storm Falcon was in the country. What about immediate damages, or maybe do you think that it can also monitor, of course, faults or anything that we should be aware of, especially once a big storm hits?
Yes, the application displays the latest official hazards information from the mandated government agencies. So for example, if you want to see volcanic and seismic hazards, we could view it in the application. If you want to see hydrometeorological hazards such as flood, rain-induced landslide, we could also see it in the application.
All right, so currently Harold is navigating our laptop, and we'll have a quick demo. So Harold, so how do we do this? Can you show us at least on how it works?
Sure, sir.
Okay, so you can just tilt the laptop a bit, and then we can have a quick demo.
So first, upon opening the Hazard Hunter URL,
we can
application.
Maximize this first. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so the first thing that you would see after opening the application would be the landing page.
Got it.
Here at the landing page would be the introduction of Hazard Hunter, its use, and the partners we have in our project. So to proceed, the next landing page would be how to use the Hazard Hunter application. So it has three steps. First, you have to double click or tap on a specific location in order to start assessing. Then an initial hazard assessment report will be generated. And then now you can select explanation and recommendation to download that as hazard assessment report. So to proceed,
just scroll down.
Scroll down and then click proceed.
Continue.
Or continue.
Okay.
So there are four ways in locating your area. So the first way, if you're using your mobile phone, is to pan through it. If you are familiar with your area, just pan through that location and then double tap to produce your hazard assessment report. Second way would be the search bar. You can input your barangay, municipality, or your street, your area, in order for you to go to that location and do your assessment.
So can we have an example, like Quezon City?
All right. Let's type Quezon City. So Quezon City. You just have to click Quezon City, and automatically it direct you to Quezon City. Now you can start panning through that location and then select your hazard.
Okay.
Or the assessment. So the third option to locate your area would be use your current location. So this would be helpful, especially if you don't know the place you are. So if you're using your mobile phone, we have GPS with our phone. You just have to use your current location and automatically it will assess the location you are. So last is use coordinates. So we are familiar with latitude and longitude. So if we know the latitude and longitude of our place, we just have to put that information, click search, and automatically it will direct you to that location.
So I from my understanding, it was just launched this week.
Yes, last July 16.
Last July 16, and it's very important for people, of course, to be able to be aware of this. So how do you think this will, you know, transcend to the people and just use this? Kumbaga, ito yung first option to be able to monitor the risks that they're in.
Okay, so the tagline of Hazard Hunter PH is hazard assessment at your fingertips. So before, we have to go to mandated government agencies to get a certificate or certification of hazard assessment report. It would take me three days or a week before getting that report. So with Hazard Hunter PH, it will be revolutionary or very useful for the public and institutions. By just a click or double tapping, you will produce those hazard assessment reports.
All right, so how do you think it will become mainstream?
Well, for Hazard Hunter, the social media campaign of GeoRisk Philippines is continuous. So we post about the application in GeoRisk PH social media platforms, as well as in FIVOX social media platforms. And we are also appealing or asking for the participation of national government agencies, local government units, and of course, the media to help us in letting the public know about Hazard Hunter PH.
So how do you think right now it will be... You're part of the development team.
Yes.
And how important is it? How do you think important is it for it to be user-friendly?
Well, for it to be user-friendly, our development team attended user experience and application development workshops. And so they worked really hard to make the application functional and easy to use. And so from the feedback we received, it's very positive, since you just have to double-click on your location on the map, and within 15 seconds, it would assess volcanic, seismic, and hydrometeorological hazards.
Are there any future plans for this app and technology to even go on a broader scale, maybe future improvements?
Yes, so we envision that Hazard Hunter PH, it is institutionalized, the hazard assessment report could be used in legal purposes, such as banks, certification in LGUs. They would have to mandate that to use Hazard Hunter PH for this assessment. Also, currently, Hazard Hunter has natural hazards such as seismic, volcanic, and hydrometeorological hazard data, plus exposure data from DepEd, DOH, and DPWH. So in the near future, when we got more partnerships, we envision that more data will be included to Hazard Hunter PH for it to be more efficient and be more useful for the government and for the public.